introduce myself. I'm Professor Shashidhara. You could call me Shashi in short. Currently the director of National Center of Biological Sciences. My area of research is developmental biology, genetics, and evolutionary biology. Typically, I'm interested in how early during development very different organs are positioned along the body axis and how do they attain specific size and shape proportional to the body size, right? But because all of these things requires very fine control early during development, growth control mechanisms, those mechanisms are the ones which I'm studying. Many signaling pathways, molecular pathways associated with the fine control are the ones which are implicated in cancer. So I now transition in the last few years to work on human cancers. Well, you know, research itself is always challenging, right? Every question that we ask, every methodology we want to adopt, whether our students are well trained in using that methodology is always challenging. In fact, I transitioned that time when molecular biology was just beginning and many of the major advanced molecular biology techniques, I myself was not trained. So the challenge was how my students should get trained when I'm not familiar with those, you know. So first thing is accepting that I don't know is very important. And then telling the student to learn from others is equally important. So one of the thing I did was to send my students to places which are very good in doing those experiments so that they can learn from the best in the world. They went to Cambridge, they went to, you know, France, they went to Germany, you know, EMBA and kind of places and learned some of the latest techniques. That's how we overcame the challenges. So, you know, faculty and good students, both are equally important. You get to attract good faculty, you need to give them freedom. You need to give them some flexibility in how they work, because the research is had to work in an open mind rather than very constrained conditions. Some research facilities are important, but faculty, good faculty, when they select, they will get funded, they themselves will establish. More important is to sort of provide an atmosphere in which research is considered important for the organization. Really exciting time, you know, like every year, decade, we always have one or other new, you know, tool that is available to do research. For example, internet itself became a tool. Data science techniques are now, you know, became tool. Now it's AI, tomorrow, for example, could be quantum computing. But, you know, if you are using it wisely, you know, it will be fantastic. Only thing is, compared to other tools, of course, every tool students have to learn first how to use it. But AI can also be made to be better learned and also should know what are the loopholes. Otherwise, it can become a disastrous. Well, there will be more team science, collaborative research, more interdisciplinarity, because with the help of AI and, you know, variety of different methods, collaboration becomes much easier. The language barriers are all taken out. So given that, I think more and more interdisciplinary research, I'm sure will come out, like clinical research or related to agriculture. But one thing is sure, because of climate change and other problems that are caused by the humans, more and more research would be addressing the environmental issues, agriculture, food and nutrition related issues, healthy aging related issues. Develop analytical skills, develop critical thinking abilities, which come when doing research. So everybody should do some research. This could be a small project, doesn't have to be a breakthrough discovery, but doing it sincerely without making any mistake, without manipulating the data or without trying to use the shortcuts. What is important in doing research is learning the essence of research methodology. Later, they can actually do much very well, irrespective of whichever the profession you take. Advantage of developing these research skills means you develop critical thinking, analytical abilities, self-learning, you know, abilities, and which all be useful everywhere in their life. Oh, it's one of the best I visited so far in the country. Really top of the class. And I really wish all of the best to all of the faculty and the students of this university.